3 mil in the morning.
Wednesday hump day, 94.1 WHRP. Tony with T-Mill in the morning. Oh, this is the saddest Wednesday I've had in a long time.
Yeah, it's hitting me.
It's not hitting you. It's hitting me. Leave me with all this stuff to do.
It's a real moment, but it is a celebration. Also, gotta
for who, T Mill? Celebration for who?
But remembering, again, we did this. We're 3 years in. And we really accomplished something here with this show.
We did. Bringing a local show in the morning to WHRP. First time ever. That's a really big deal to have a local show speak to the community every day.
Yeah.
And this would not have happened without you willing to jump in on and make it happen.
Well, you got to have a good coach, too.
You
try to find a team, you got to find the right team to play for.
It's too late to brown nose me. All right, so the buttering up is not working anymore. I don't know why you keep buttering me up.
I just got to make sure that last check clears.
Real talk. But for those who are just checking in, T-Mill is parting ways with the morning show, going on to, it better be bigger and better.
right.
And a great opportunity for you to take care of everything you need to take care of. And hopefully you walk away feeling good about everything you did here, because you did a lot.
Yes.
And helping to make this a great morning show. So that said, starting Monday. Anyway, let's just get back to the news.
All right. Well, you remember Patti LaBelle and Master P claiming that she only owned 10% of her patty pies.
What?
Patti LaBelle coming out saying,
she kicked her shoes off.
You better get my name right.
Hello. And Kim Kardashian is being accused of actually paying for her daughter to be in the Lion King role that most recently played. Yeah.
All right. And is Iggy Azalea dissing SZA?
What?
SZA with the number one album, SZA?
Are you kidding me? Iggy Azalea, who thinks she can rap but can't. That person? Is that
the
who
year
you?
Of the diss.
I'm just asking questions. All right. And one of my favorite basketball stars had a baby. We're going to talk about that. Stay with us. Tony with T-Mill in the morning, 94.1 WHRP.
You're spending your morning with your neighbors. Tony with T-Mill in the morning on 94.1 WHRP.
Who ends their time on a job on a Wednesday? Who does that?
I feel like the person
that's full of shenanigans. It's the only word I can say on radio and not get fined.
If time will tell and we can go back, I'm curious of when we started, because I feel like we started in the middle of the week.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
All you have to do is go back to, I think, 2021 on May 3rd. So let's look that up. May 3rd, 2021. What day was that?
Google.
What day was May 3rd, 2021? Let's see. Oh, my. It was a Monday. Who the heck starts a job on a Wednesday and leaves a job on a Wednesday? Full of shenanigans, ladies and gentlemen.
Hey, I learned from the best. Because you know what tomorrow is? The best of.
So for those who are just waking up from sleeping under a rock, and don't know, T-Mill is parting ways with the morning show. This is his last day on mornings, but you'll catch him on Saturday mornings
from 9
until 12 for Taking It Back with T-Mill. In other words, he tired of me.
He won't work
by himself.
That ain't it.
Spread rumors.
That ain't it.
Start some stuff on the internet.
You got to transition sometimes, and you have to also, teams. I look at this as a team. Mm-hmm. Tony and T-Mill.
Well, you saw what happened to the Commodores after Lionel left. Hello? Is it me you're looking for? You're the Commodores.
Gots to be more careful.
Wow. See how many hits you get after this.
It never works. You look at any group.
Any group.
It never works.
You saw what happened to the Jacksons after Michael went on. And I'm just saying.
So, yeah.
But yeah, I'm going to miss you a lot. You know, it's been a great journey through the ups and downs of radio and life.
Making history and being in the community.
Yes.
Also able to, live and local radio.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, and for our community, we have been wanting something in the morning to start our days off with. And hey, you came along and said, let's make it happen. That was a big leap of faith, no doubt, because you didn't. You're like, who? What? What you talking about?
Hey, I didn't know if I could make it. I didn't know if this would be a real thing. I always had dreams or aspirations of doing radio, and just trying to be prepared for a day like this. But you never know.
You're right.
And like they say, opportunity best serves the prepared.
Yeah.
And you just got to be prepared
when
for.
When you least expect it, you never know who may be knocking on your door, calling you, or reaching out.
Always least expected.
Or watching your podcast.
Yep.
Snooping around.
So moral of the story.
Right.
Just to keep your head down, do your job.
So what happens after this? We have PT that will be in the building starting Monday, June 3rd.
Yeah.
You started on May 3rd. He starts on June 3rd. I'm starting to think this is not a good omen. The 3rd.
Just play the threes.
I'm telling you, man, I'm going to start dreaming threes now. I'm like, wait a minute. Maybe I should start him on the 4th.
Well,
maybe we should take Monday off. Like, hey, this is your first day off, PT. We're going to start on Tuesday.
Follow your first thought.
You know. Just so I don't have a repeat.
You've always been a genius before.
Well, I excuse me?
Yeah.
Still.
Still.
What?
And when they write the biopic, all of this will make sense.
Yeah.
And, at the end, when they do the stills, and it's like, and it has the description on the screen of Tony goes on to live her life and she got the lottery and she took over the world and the world finally knew that she was a genius. And T-Mill went back to working for Tony, the genius.
No. T-Mill's looking for Tony with that bag.
Tony with T-Bill in the morning, 94.1 WHRP.
We looking black in the day.
Was that black?
We're looking back in the day.
Back. Well, back in the day, jazz composer and vibraphonist Mr. Roy Ayers was given his first set of vibraphone mallets by band leader, the great Lionel Hampton. Mr. Ayers released his first album in 1968, and by the 1990s, his music was remixed, covered, and sampled by the emerging hip-hop generation artists such as Mos Def, Puff Daddy, Mary J. Blige, and a few others. Plus, singer Erykah Badu has dubbed Mr. Ayers the godfather of neo-soul.
Come on now.
Now, that's black in the day. On this date in 1886, the creator of Coca-Cola, John Pemberton, began advertising his new drink. It was 1976. Diana Ross went disco with Love Hangover, which hit number one on the charts. Tina Turner released her comeback album, I'm Your Prime. The Dancer, on this date in 1984. It was 1984 that the Fat Boys put out their self-titled debut album, and LL Cool J released his second album, Bigger and Deafer, on this date in 1987. Got a couple of celebrities and famous people, too, celebrating birthdays.
Future Basketball Hall of Famer Carmelo Anthony and the oldest Jackson sibling, Rebe Jackson. That was her crown and glory. And another Jackson sibling, LaToya Jackson. Eccentric, to say the least. Aaron Magruder, the creator of the Boondocks series, and also Laverne Cox, the breakthrough actress and LGBTQ activist. Mel B, you remember her as Scary Spice from the Spice Girls, and four-time Academy Award nominee Annette Bening. And in memoriam today, we remember John F. Kennedy, the 35th President of the United States. Check out our Facebook page at 941WHRP for more celebrity birthdays.
And today is National Flip-Flop Day, so you can show off your pair of slippers.
Hey, hey!
Make sure you got that Medi going on. All right, that's Black of the Day, Back in the Day. Tony with T-Mill in the Morning, 94.1 WHRP.
94.1 WHRP, Gurley, Huntsville, Decatur, a Cumulus Media station.
Tony! With T-Mill in the Morning.
You ever get that person? You ever the one person that's like staring at you when you're at the time clock, and you're like, "Are you waiting? Am I in your way? Like, what are you waiting for?"
The majority of my working career has not been in a position to use time clocks.
Yeah,
but I did have a spell when I did, and I didn't understand it because I've been working in radio for so long.
Mm-hmm.
I had one of those moments where I had to take a job outside of the industry, and so you had to a card, and mm-hmm. you had to put it in this little thing, you know, stamped it or whatever.
Yeah, yeah.
And so I did that, and I needed to go, like, I don't know, like, do something.
Mm-hmm.
Like, I'm so used to this, like, I gotta go do something.
Yeah.
And the lady was like, "You can't just go do something. You have to let me know before you." I'm like, "What?" And so I'm like, this is what people are doing out here at different organizations and employment.
Ain't got nothing to do with them.
Yeah. They have to clock in to go use the clock out to go use the bathroom,
mm-hmm.
or whatever for 15 minutes. And that, oh my, once you clock it out,
yeah,
you have the clock is ticking. You got to hurry up and hope they got toilet paper. And you're not, you know,
bathroom way on the other side of the building.
What, that? Wash your hands. Please don't talk to me. How you doing? None of your business. I got to go. The clock is ticking. And you got to get back.
15 minutes ain't enough.
And you got to clock that thing back in, that put that little paper thing back in. I don't know if they're doing that now. It's probably all digital. But I was like, whoa, this is, they're like, one day, a manager came to me and said, I really don't think this is a good career for you.
How observant.
Why do you think I'm back in radio? No, I just couldn't handle it.
Nice, nasty.
You did very that. Nice, nasty. I was trying to change the way they do things.
Yeah.
I'm like, this is not how you treat people, you know. You can't predict when people have to use a restroom.
No.
You know,
and some like places that. Are still doing that. Like mm-hmm. a lot of the manufacturing jobs mm-hmm. and, you know, factories and plants, you know,
right.
you get 10 minutes for this or 30 minutes for this, and they are on time.
How can you eat lunch in 30 minutes and for your to have a proper digestive lunch?
You don't. You just have to drink it. That sub
Man.
Sandwich.
Everything's in a blender. Golly.
Right.
That's why they got all those blenders on the go for sale.
Mm-hmm.
Man.
Buffalo wings.
We have got
put them in a blender. That cheeseburger. Put it in a blender. Ooh, that Caesar salad.
Put it
in a
blender. Oh, my goodness. That leftover meatloaf.
And a biscuit. Put it in a blender.
We have got to be, we've got to get better on treating humans as humans at these places of employment.
Yep.
Well,
yep.
listen.
And you about to be late back to work. Go ahead and clock back in. Hurry up.
Man. And don't forget to clock in.
Oh, yeah. You got to get paid now.
Oh, my gosh. If you forget to clock back in,
you're
still on break. They're going to deduct that.
Woo! Why my check short?
These are not good memories for me, T-Mail. Not at all. Well, it's Judgment Day. Judgment Day for the Orange Man. You know, he's been dealing with his hush money trial, and you've got about 12 jurors. I think there's about 5 women on the jury. And they're going to make some decisions today on whether or not he should go to the Gray Bar Hotel / Motel Holiday Inn.
Say what?
Or does he get to walk around free?
This has to be
with an ankle bracelet.
A first in history where
it is.
Jurors are deciding the fate
mm-hmm.
of a former president that is on trial for hush money. You got the January 6th insurrection. You've got hiding documents. And like, how many counts? Was it like 80-something?
Felony charges.
30. And he's still running for president.
No, he's still out. He's still running around. Yeah, the guy's delusional and all of his fans. So it's a very serious situation because the rhetoric of which he shares – and talks about doing if he were to get back into position is very scary.
So what does that say if they let him go and they say, hey, we find him not guilty on all these charges?
They say the same thing they've been saying. White people can do whatever the heck they want to do.
The 4.1 WHRP.
Hey, Teddy swims. Oh, that's how you said it? That sounded like came from the bottom of his feet.
You're right.
Be careful.
Oh.
Tony with T-Mail in the morning.
Don't
Teddy
wake her
swims,
up.
Lose
it's
control.
Early.
That's how you wake her up.
Only thing that's woke is that hair.
Is it like Candyman? You go in the mirror and go, I feel like falling. She pops out with a cowboy hat on. Oh, Sasha Fierce comes in. There you go.
Texas. I know it ain't Texas. It's Alabama. She's on a road trip. Wake up every time she wakes up. You know, they have those tour buses.
Yeah.
And every time she wakes up, she's like, this ain't Texas. I know, it's Ohio.
New York City.
Right. How'd you come up with the title? Every time she wakes up, we're on a road trip.
Are we home yet?
This ain't Texas. I know it's not.
So instead of her saying, are we home yet?
Right.
This ain't Texas.
Arkansas. Most people say, are we there yet? But no, not her.
This ain't Texas. Why do her eyes do that when she wakes up? Oh, it's like the Incredible Hulk.
Oh, man. You know how to get your hair nice and fluffy.
How?
If you're leaving, if your hair is going to bed on a mannequin, you take it off and just shake it.
Oh.
Yeah.
That's how you do it?
What does that have to do with anything?
Put the soul glow?
I don't know. It ain't Texas.
It ain't Texas.
No.
It's just hair.
It's just hair.
Well, check this out. I found this story of our Aunt Patty. Patty LaBelle.
Patty. Pies and what else? Cakes and...
pancakes and syrup and all type of stuff. And there was a video with Master P a while back.
Right.
He was doing a master class. Master P said that Patty LaBelle owns 10%. So if you're buying the Patty LaBelle name, the company Walmart made $200 million. How much of that you think went to Patty?
Mm-hmm.
And where did the other $180 million go?
Okay.
He said, so you're trying to buy into these black-owned brands, you really need to do your research because it's not 100% black-owned. And she only owns 10%
This is what
Patty
he's saying,
pies.
Right?
Yeah, this is Master P. It ain't me. Get it right. It ain't T-Mill saying it. This ain't T-Mill. So Patty LaBelle's, one of her business partners, Charles Suit, he came out and said, yeah, Charles Suit. The man's last name is Suit.
Oh, Suit.
Or maybe
okay.
Sweet.
Okay.
Charles Suit.
Okay.
And he comes out and he says, hey, Master P done lost his mind, all due respect.
Oh.
He said that master class, in order for you to teach a master class, you should have done your research.
Oops.
He said, Walmart doesn't own anything. They own 0% of that pie, and Patty owns 100%. He says Walmart buys the pies from us at a wholesale price,
okay,
and then they sell them at retail.
Okay.
He says, so I don't know where he got his information.
Mm-hmm.
And then he, you know, kind of put a little dig in him.
Right.
He said, well, Master P is reckless, and he's only suing Walmart now because he feels like his product was not being promoted, and it's not up front. He says maybe he needs to have a conversation on his dealings with Walmart, but we're good over here.
And now he can't even ask Patty how she got her deal.
Nope.
Listen to
Tony with T-Mail in the morning.
Oh, I see you're showing off on your last day. You got a special guest that's going to join us.
Yeah, got to leave on a high note and make sure everybody is ready for Bruce. Bruce coming to Huntsville this weekend. Stand up live Friday, Saturday, and Sunday.
Mm-hmm.
He's on the way to talk about what he's bringing to the Ville.
Okay.
And some of his favorites about his comedy career.
All right. Looking forward to Bruce. Bruce, stick around. Spending a little time with T-Mail before he leaves us on the morning show. There's no other way to say it.
Yeah, yeah. You're going to make me cry.
You are leaving us.
And T-Mail in the morning.
That's y'all.
Y'all with these shenanigans, y'all. I'm trying to get out here on the last day.
With the satin draws.
Satin draws.
Primetime 256 joining us and surprising T-Mill this morning.
Oh, my goodness.
I posted it on my Facebook page.
Oh, yeah. Man. I hope that you didn't post me crying. And those are thug tears that you see.
Oh, thug tears.
Thug tears.
Right. We are celebrating.
I'm not crying. I got allergies.
That's what it is.
That's right.
Certain to think.
A chew. T-Mill leaving the morning show. And today, the last day, Tony with T-Mill in the morning. You know, T-Mill, going to be pretty much the last couple of days we'll hear that famous jingle.
Yeah, but I got it already on my playlist. Mm-hmm. So, you know, right. I've got it in my playlist to listen to it every morning because I still got to start my morning with that, Kelvin Wooten doing mm-hmm. this thing on there. And it really, that in itself is like one of the other parts of this show that I'm really proud of, where it just makes you, when things are coming together and people are helping out and you hear that, to have a person of that stature and all of his hard work in the industry, of how much he believed in the show as well.
And being a local.
Someone right here that we can champion. Mm-hmm. You know, we look at all these other superstars and producers in the world, but we have one right here.
You can produce songs for SZA and Earth, Wind & Fire and Jill Scott.
Jasmine Sullivan.
J. Cole and all that. Yeah.
Well, and Tony and T-Mill.
Well, the point is, you know, these big famous singers that have all these great hits. Their songs will never be played as much as our jingle.
Come on now.
Come on. Every morning.
Multiple
times.
Go up a chart mm-hmm. and they come down, but ours
stays up. And I'm going to keep it on my
good
playlist.
Good move, Kelvin Wooten.
But y'all surprised me again on the last day, you know, parting gifts and sentiments. And I'm not afraid to say that I am sentimental and tears of joy mm-hmm. in doing this, moving on this chapter. But to know that, you know, a guy like PT, Primetime 256, is coming in and his energy, you can tell, you know, I don't have as much energy as he has. This guy is going to be on 10 every single morning.
What you talking about, T-Man? What you talking about?
He is the guy, and when I thought about, you know, who's ready for this, there's a lot of people that, you know, have potential, but sometimes, again, on a team or in sports, you got to find people that are ready and may already be more ready than they know.
Right.
And also to compliment who they're going to be on the air with. I'm like, I ain't just going to be reckoning anybody for Tony, man. I got to make sure it's someone.
Because I will be coming knocking on your door. This is who you stuck me with?
The first thing T-Mill asked me, he said, are you prepared for budget cuts?
Yeah. That's right.
Did you come with your budget, own sound effects?
Exactly.
Now, T-Mill, I came with the budget cuts. Was I prepared with the gift, man?
Yes, very much. And shout out to DJ Your Boy Boy. Shout out to DJ Blue. Shout out to DJ Primetime 256, the DJ Cartel, and our local DJs. I really appreciate y'all because that gift, I never.
He didn't see it coming.
I didn't.
Unless
see
he looked
that.
On the backside of the wrapping paper.
Yeah, because now explain this wrapping paper situation.
If you go on to my Facebook page, you'll see half wrap. So, which means he is prepared for the show because we have a half budget.
You feel
so
me?
You can
he used that roll from Christmas that only had like a foot left of roll wrapping paper on it. It was like, yeah, this will do.
But it was a great presentation. You saw the front of it. It was signed and everything. As long as you didn't turn the package around.
There you go.
And the package didn't have BBL. Okay, it didn't have no BBL.
BBL package.
We are getting a little closer to the old school song of the day. You can pick that last song because it will be your last song to pick.
Is that like a last meal?
Right. And Primetime 256 will be starting Monday.
Yes.
Tomorrow and Friday will be the best of Tony with T-Mill in the morning. And then the new journey of the morning show will kick off on June 3rd. But before then, we've got our old school song of the day coming up on 94.1 WHRP.
94.1 WHRP. Girly, Huntsville, Decatur, a Cumulus Media station. Tony with T-Mill in the morning. Laughs, informative, and just a little crazy. Tony with T-Mill in the morning. 94.1 WHRP. Tony with T-Mill in the morning. This is the Tony with T-Mill in the morning show.
It's WHRP. Tony with T-Mill in the morning. Wednesday, hump day, beautiful weather outside, and a perfect time to make a store run to get some of these new Welch's.
Oh, man, yeah. Welch's is coming up with canned cocktails.
Hey!
Now, the thing of it is, you've got to be careful because a lot of people buy the Welch's box drinks in the little bottles for their children, right?
Yeah.
We all like the Welch's drinks, but this is going to be a little different. The Welch's craft cocktails will include vodka. They will have like a watermelon mule, passion fruit mojito. And each of these cocktails will have at least 6% alcohol.
Yeah, the vodka one they're calling vodka transfusion.
Whatever. Sound like a mixed drink to me.
A vodka cranberry.
Yeah.
Ooh-wee.
So that's, you know, old schoolers, a lot of us grew up drinking Welch's. That grape juice is still, boy. Man,
ice cold.
You put that in the freezer. Oh, my gosh.
So they got to be careful on this because I'm pretty sure, you know, a lot of our, you know, our institutions of worship have the Welch's tap.
I'm moving away from the mic. You can start some messing on your last day if you want to.
But they got to be careful because this look—it's that Welch's logo and those grapes on the front. Mm-hmm. You could easily pick this up and think that, oh, I'm just getting
time
some Welch's
for communion.
Well, speaking of that, check this out. They're talking grand jury investigation into Diddy.
Oh.
Federal investigators, they say, are coming around to possibly getting a grand jury together to start listening to evidence and presenting.
Oh, my.
So it's getting really real in this because there hadn't been, you know, there was a lawsuit with Cassie.
Sure.
But now this is sounding like, you know, the raid that they had on his house there. And then, like you said, the new allegations that have come to front in New York, they got the grand jury that's coming together. So we're going to have to keep an eye on this and see what's happening.
We better tell PT to get on top of this story since you won't be here next week to fill us in. I'm going to be like, what happened?
Right. To be continued.
To be continued.
Previously on Tony T-Mill
in the morning. Oh, they canceled that show.
94.1 WHRP, Gurley, Huntsville, Decatur, a Cumulus Media station. Tony with T-Mill in the morning. Laughs, informative, and just a little crazy. Tony with T-Mill in the morning. On 94.1 WHRP, Tony with T-Mill in the morning. This is the Tony with T-Mill in the morning show.
It's time. When you hear the new jingle, think of me.
That's the whole point. So they could stop thinking of you. That's why we got to put a new jingle in. You got a whole jingle. T-Mill in the morning.
It ain't gonna go like that. Kelvin don't sound like that on there.
Sounds like that now to me. It says it one time. Tony! T-Mill in the morning. I'm like, ain't that some mess?
Oh, my goodness.
I'm going to fix that.
Do a remix?
I'm going to fix that.
Oh, she's got an AI version.
You're
going to
hear my name next time.
Tony with Tony. With Tony,
Tony, Tony.
The new Tony, 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 Tony.
We'll see if we can squeeze PT's name somewhere. I learned my lesson. Don't put the name on the jingle. I learned my lesson.
Oh, my
goodness. Tony, T-Mill in your mouth.
Time for your motivation and inspiration.
It's Wednesday.
Uh-huh.
Who stops working a job on a Wednesday? Okay. People who want to get a four-day work.
Oh, that's not the inspiration?
Yeah, right. No. But this motivation and inspiration is just for you, T-Mill.
Uh-oh.
Everyone else can take this in if they choose to. But this motivation and inspiration is for you. This is a Wednesday blessing for you.
Oh, okay.
All right. Whew. Enjoy God's favor today. and each day that follows, God will hear your voice and he will comfort you with grace as you follow his steps. That is your motivation and inspiration, T-Mill, on this Wednesday.
Thank you.
Spending your morning with your neighbors. Tony with T-Mill in the morning on 94.1 WHRP. 94.